Oh, hello, guys. Happy Mother's Day, everybody. And for this year's Mother's Day video special that I'm going to be doing is a movie review. It's going to be on Rugrats in Paris, the movie from the year 2000. So enjoy this video. Cue the intro, please. Hello guys, Jonathan's Media Corner here, and today, happy Mother's Day everybody, and for today's video, it's a movie review once again, but this time, it'll be on Rugrats in Paris, the movie, came in the year of 2000. So basically what the plot is, it takes place in a wedding reception of Lou Pickles and his new wife, Lulu, a mother-child dance during the reception. Saddens Chucky Finster and his father, Chas. And as Miss Finster died of a terminal illness shortly after Chucky was born, Tommy Pickles' father, Stu, is summoned to Euro Reptile Land, a Japanese amusement park in Paris, in France, to mix a malfunctioning reptile robot meant to star in a stage show. Due to Stu being called during night because of the time difference, he then mistakenly brings his wife Dee Dee and his dog Spike, his sons Tommy and Dill and Chucky, Phil, Lil, Angelica, and their parents along to Paris to visit the park. And then they arrive at the Euro Reptile Land, and Angelica overhears a phone conversation between the park's cold-hearted, child-hating head, Coco Labougie, and the president of the reptile franchise, Mr. Yamaguchi. Coco wants to be named Yamaguchi's successor, but Yamaguchi says his successor must love children. Therefore, she lies, and she says that she is engaged to a man with a child. But then she later discovers that Angelica overheard to save herself. Angelica reveals that Chas is looking for a second wife. And then Coco strikes up a relationship with Chas, but her attempts to bond with a suspicious Chucky fail. The adults and babies meet Coco's overworked but a warm-hearted assistant, Kira Watanabe, and her daughter, Kimmy, who hail from Japan. Kira reluctantly helps Coco to win Chas's affection. Meanwhile, Spike gets lost in the streets of Paris and falls in love with a stray poodle named Fifi. Kira tells the babies the origins of Reptar, explaining that he was a field monster, until a princess revealed his gentler side to make the frightened humans like him. Chucky decides the princess should be his new mother, and he and his friends attempt to reach an animatronic replica of the princess in the park, but they are stopped by Coco's security team. At the Reptar show's premiere, Angelica informs Coco of Chucky's wish. Coco sneaks onto the stage and takes a spotlight, disguised as a princess, luring Chucky into her arms and taking his teddy bear. Chucky is then petrified to discover the truth, but Chas is ecstatic and instantly decides to marry her. On her wedding day, Coco has her accomplice, Jean-Claude K. kidnaps the baby, and then they kidnap the babies and Angelica to prevent them from ruining her plans. He locks them in a warehouse where the show's robots are kept. Kira protests and threatens to reveal Coco's plan to Chaz, but Coco throws her out of the taxi they are in, leaving Kira to hurry to the wedding via bicycle. Chucky then apologizes for getting the babies into trouble, lamenting his lost mother. Angelica then feels guilty, revealing her part in Coco's plan, and also apologizes. Chucky rallies the children to use the reptile robot to hurry to Notre Dame. To stop the wedding, picking up Kimmy along the way, Jean-Claude follows, piloting Reptar's nemesis, Robo-Snail, until he is defeated, and when Chucky knocks him into the Seine River. Later, the babies arrive at Notre Dame, interrupting the wedding just in time. Jean-Claude appears and inadvertently announces a kidnapping, and Chaz calls the wedding off in disgust, meaning that he figured out Coco's true nature, realizing that he sees Coco's true nature, and her true nature is cold-hearted and a child-hating woman. And then Angelica divulges Coco's plans to Yamaguchi, who is also in attendance, and fires Coco on the spot. When the babies inadvertently step on Coco's wedding dress and she pulls it out from under them in front of everyone, Angelica tears the dress in retaliation, exposing Coco's undergarments. She storms out of the cathedral humiliated and defeated, while Spike chases Jean-Claude away. Kira arrives, returning Chucky's teddy bear to him, and apologizes for Chaz for not revealing Coco's plan sooner. However, Chaz admits that he was fooled by the romance of Paris and apologizes to Chucky. He and Kira begin to fall in love after discovering a shared liking of the same poem. Chaz and Kira eventually get married after returning to the United States, while Fifi is adopted after the new family takes their first dance together, and then the entire dance floor had been erupted into an all-out food fight instigated by the babies. And that's basically what the plot for the entire movie is. What do I think about this movie? This is a magnificent movie. Yeah, I really like this movie. I really like how they focus on Chucky finding a new... on them going to Paris and France, and Chaz falls in love. At least he falls in love with Coco Labouchi, but at the end, Chaz finds out her true nature, and he falls in love with another girl. Yeah. In the beginning, Chucky felt very forlorn because of the loss of his own mother due to the terminal illness. But at the end, Chucky got a new mother, and he and Kimmy along, and he got Kimmy as well. And Chucky, Chaz, and Kimmy, and Kira are all one big happy family. Yeah. And there are some funny moments as well. Like when the babies were playing, when Coco Labouchi sees the babies, she freaks out. Another thing is when, oh my god. Yeah. When Angelica tears Coco Labouchi's wedding dress, Jean-Claude says, "I see London, I see France, I see Coco's underpants." And the end, where the babies had a food fight and everyone did. Oh my god. Fantastic. And Coco Labouchi, she's a great villain. I mean, she's like a cold-hearted woman that You find her very menacing because, yeah, especially when it comes to children, she's a child-hating woman. And I like how Spike got a girlfriend as well. Yeah, you could tell. And I like how they went to France and go to Ewa Reptile Land. Wow! The Ewa Reptile Land sounds really interesting. I know it's only a movie, but still, the way that they went, this is just incredible. And the animation stays true to the original TV show Rugrats. Yeah, I really like this movie, especially when it takes place in Paris. The music in it is lovely as well. I like the music as well. And this movie had grossed $76.5 million in North America and $26.8 million in other territories. Yeah. This really was a fun movie. And this movie is based on a Nickelodeon show, the popular Nickelodeon show Rugrats. And I like how they brought the original voice actors and actresses and put new ones like Susan Sarandon, John Lithgow. Yeah, I like that idea, and they did an amazing job. The voice actors and actresses did such an amazing job, and it really lives up to the type, and it really stays true to the hit Nickelodeon show Rugrats. So yeah, even the characters were likable. Even the show itself, they were likable. And in the first movie, the Rugrats movie, they were likable too. Which I'll do a review on the Rugrats movie maybe someday. Maybe next year, or who knows. Maybe I'll do it in January of next year, so stay tuned for that. So yeah, next year I'll do a review on the Rugrats movie in January. This year it's Rugrats in Paris in the movie. And yeah, this is a really fun movie. The music, the animation, the characters, everything I could say about it, it's a true Nickelodeon movie classic. So if you haven't seen Rugrats in Paris the movie, where have you been? This is such an amazing movie. You have to check that out. The characters are cute as well. And everything is just a true masterpiece from the 2000s. And it's also one of my favorite animated movies of the 2000s, along with The Emperor's New Groove. So yeah, for my final rating for Rugrats in Paris the movie, I'm going to give this movie a 7 out of 7. Outstanding movie. And there you go. That was my review on Rugrats in Paris the movie. Thank you for watching, guys. Happy Mother's Day, everybody. Make sure you comment, like, and subscribe to me. This is Jonathan's Media Corner signing off, and I'll see you guys later. Peace out, y'all, and have a great day.